Hello again and welcome to our new tree vlog. It's very dry in the nursery currently. You can see the dust flying through the air here. The recent years we have discovered that there's big peaks in or a lot of rainfall or no rain for weeks at all. So there's more demand coming for trees that are more drought resistant. So we're going to take a look at some trees in the nursery that can withstand longer periods without any rain. So let's have a look. I'm standing in between two rows of Quercus imbricaria. And Quercus imbricaria, that is a tree that originates from the center and southeastern part of the United States. It's a tree that can grow up to 15 to 25 meters in height, so it can become a quite large tree. And if you take a look at the leaf, most of you won't recognize it as a typical oak leaf. It looks more like a laurel leaf. It's a bit lobed, it's quite flat, and it's very healthy, doesn't get any mildew during the summertime. And in the autumn, this leaf turns totally red, so it has a very nice autumn coloration. And it stays on the trees also quite long during the winter time, and it only falls off later in spring. The bark is also very special. Usually it's quite smooth. When it gets more mature, you get more grooves in the bark itself. And the bark is also that has given the name to the tree, because imber means rain shower in Latin. So people used to cut tiles for the roof of this oak, and they would put them on the roof against the rain. So that's where the name comes from. A tree that can withstand de-icing salt on the road, can grow in industrial areas. It's a very nice and healthy tree, Quercus imbricaria. Would you like to be informed about our latest videos? Then subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm standing here in front of two rows of quite big Celtis julianae. Celtis julianae is family of the nettle tree family, and the leaf feels a bit like sandpaper if you touch it. In the past, people thought this was a part of the elm family, which is not, because it's a part of the hemp family, so to speak. I never tried to smoke the leaves, but I don't think it'll get much effect. The tree can grow up to 15 to 20 meters in height. It originates from central China, where it is quite hot in the summer as well. And it has a quite loose crown, and the branches are quite elegant hanging. It's quite open, and as you can see, the trees are not affected after 6 weeks without any rain or without any water here in the nursery. So they can be planted in a half pavement on industrial areas. It's a very strong and healthy tree, not very well known on the market, but it's very suitable. Celtis julianae. Here we have a multi-stemmed form of Gleditsia triacanthus Shade Master. The name is Shade Master, but this one doesn't provide more shade than a normal Gleditsia triacanthus or the other cultivars. But it's a nice and healthy tree, which can grow up to 20 to 25 meters in height. It's an American selection, and it doesn't have any thorns on the branches, so it's quite easy to handle. It can be planted in paved surfaces. It can withstand a lot of heat and drought, of course. It has a nice autumn coloration, and also the flowers attract a lot of bees. It's a good bee tree. So an ideal tree to be planted in the city, Gleditsia triacanthus Shade Master. This is Pinus pinaster, or maritime pine. This pine originates from the southwestern part of Europe, and also from the north western part of Africa, like in Morocco. This one is used a lot in southwestern France, in the sand dune areas, to prevent them from making more bigger dunes. So it's a tree that can withstand a lot of drought and a lot of heat and can also grow directly on the coastline. So it's also not vulnerable to salty sea wind. It's a tree that can grow up to 25 to 40 meters in height, so it's an enormous tree. Also the trunk flakes off later on in small plates, which is a very nice look. And the needles are quite long and always together in bundles of two. And these are the cones, which are quite large as well. It's a tree that's not so winter hardy as the normal pine, but like I said, if you use it on the coastline in the southeastern part of Europe, it grows quite nicely. It's not suitable for heavy soils, more on really sandy soils. Pinus pinacer. This is Coroteria paniculata, or varnish tree in English. The tree originates from northern China and Korea, and also from the more dry and colder areas. It's a tree that can grow from 7 meters up to 17 meters in height, and it also has a very large spread. It has a quite open crown and a quite exotic appearance. If you take a look at the leaves, they will turn orange red in the autumn, and actually they are flowering with large yellow flower, and those flowers attract a lot of bees and bumblebees currently. This is quite an actual theme at the moment, so it's a very good bee tree, so to speak. Also the bark is nice and curved, and as you can see, they can withstand a lot of drought. It can be planted in parks, but also as a street tree with a lot of open space underneath, it can be applied. So it's a very nice and healthy tree. Coroteria paniculata. Here we have a Dutch Tilia cordata selection called Roelvo. And Roelvo was discovered in the late 80s, and this one grows a bit more upright and a bit more slender than normal Tilia cordata does. It has a very healthy leaf. You can see it has hardly any aphids on it, so it doesn't have drip from the trees, so to speak. It's a tree that can grow from 12 until 15 meters in height. It can be used as a street tree, also on the coastline and in the industrial areas. Can grow on a lot of different soil types. It's a very versatile, healthy tree, which is not so well known as Tilia cordata greenspire, for example, but even better than that one, I would say. So, Tilia cordata Roelvo. Well, I hope you got a better insight into drought-resistant trees. Thanks for watching this video, and hopefully we'll see you next time again. Bye-bye.